here, ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States. That official announcement will be coming shortly. At that time, I'll be putting down the mic and we'll be bringing you the President's remarks in their entirety.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the 40th
of the United States, Donald J. Trump.
Crowd. This is a hell of a crowd. Well, I just want to say hello, Pennsylvania, and hello, Montoursville. How are you? We love this state. I've done a little traveling in this state today, you might have heard. But we save the best for last, right? It's a great place. I went to school here, went to college here. And it's a great place. 3 days from now, we are going to win the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. And we are going to win 4 more great years in the White House. And with your vote, we will continue to bring back your jobs, cut your taxes, cut regulations, support our great military, take care of our veterans, and nobody's done it better than we have. Work with our police officers, and ensure that more products are proudly stamped with that beautiful phrase, made in the USA, right? Been a long time since you heard that kind of stuff. Next year will be the greatest economic year in the history of our country, on the assumption you don't quadruple your taxes, okay? It's the only guy I've ever seen. His whole campaign theme, we will raise your taxes. What the hell kind of a campaign? You know, my whole life I've seen people campaign. I've never heard that one before, but it's a little bit of a different kind of a campaign, wouldn't you say? Sleepy Joe Biden will shut down your economy, ship your jobs to China, raise you where he's very well taken care of. He's very well. You'll never hear it from them. It's a lot of media. You'll never hear it from the fake media. Raise your taxes, $4 trillion, destroy the suburbs, and we're saving the suburbs. I hope the people in the suburbs know that. I hope the people in the suburbs know that. I ended a regulation. If they reenact it, you won't have suburbs anymore. And send your state into a deep and crippling depression. Biden has vowed to abolish American oil and natural gas. You saw that. No fracking, no mining, no coal, no nothing. And gas prices for your beautiful large vans and cars and trucks. Some of you have trucks that you drive around in because you like that better. I think I'd be one of those people. But, you know, don't you like $2 gasoline? Isn't that nice? Well, it'll go to $6, $7, and then they'll say, you'll be telling your family, let's buy one of those little compacts that we used to buy, right? Biden's plan is an economic death sentence for Pennsylvania. He'll outlaw fracking, and what we're going to do, we're going to stop it. We're going to stop it. We have a little thing up there. Where is it? We're right there. That cost a lot of money to get. We get that for special. You're going to see a little bit about fracking. But all of that great stuff, your natural gas in Pennsylvania, and they'll obliterate and extinguish your economy. Sure as you can, as sure as you're standing and or sitting. Do you have chairs? Yeah, you do. But everybody's standing. That's very nice. Today I signed an order, and this is semi-breaking news. I did say it at the last stop, but I won't tell you that. But today I signed an order to, just now on the plane, to strongly protect your state's energy and fracking industry. I just signed it. I just signed it. We have an order so that people cannot play with your fracking industry. You know, it's your biggest. You have 1 million people, and you're a big contributor to the rest of the country. You're a tremendous contributor to the rest of the country. They can't play with it. You know, Biden said for a year, there'll be no fracking, no fracking, no. He must have said it 100 times. Then he lucks out because Elizabeth Warren refused to get out of the race. So, Bernie, that's the second time. Is Bernie running again? Fake news, could you tell us? Is Bernie? Bernie's going to run again in 4 years. He's going to get it. Actually, we thought it might be Bernie, right? More intelligence, although, I don't know, with a policy like that, I don't call that great intelligence, right, Congressman, right? If Biden and Harris get in, they will terminate this executive order and implement the Green New Deal, conceived and dedicated by AOC, who probably never took a course on the environment, right? Think she ever took one little course, like 101, Environment 101? I doubt it. To change our whole country around, well, it's not going to happen. It's so ridiculous. $100 trillion. I don't think so. A vote for Biden and Harris is a vote to ban fracking, ban mining, and completely destroy Pennsylvania. That's true, by the way. Not going to happen. First of all, we're going to win. You got to get out and vote. We're going to win. A vote for me is a vote to remain energy. We're energy independent now. Think of it. Energy independent. Our economy is now growing at the fastest rate ever recorded, 33.1%, and the fake news doesn't want to talk about it. And a friend of mine, a great financier, called up and he said, hey, how you doing? This is the greatest number maybe ever put out economically. GDP, 33.1. Nobody's ever heard of it. And they hardly... He said, I can't believe this isn't a much bigger story. I said, that's the way it is. They don't want that kind of thing to get out. It's one of the greatest numbers ever revealed in the history of our country. The second number, I think, was 1952, and it was less than half the 33.1. So we have not a V anymore. We have a super V, and that's where we're going. Unless somebody comes along and says, let's quadruple your taxes. Let's put all those regulations back. In the past 5 months, we've created a record 11.4 million American jobs. That's another. I mean, think of it. It's never been done before. And while foreign nations are in a free fall, and you see that, and we don't want that, but you see what's going on. It's COVID or the China virus or the China plague. There's about 21 different names. We're creating the world's greatest economic powerhouse. And next year will be one of the greatest years, maybe the best year that we've ever had based on what's happening. A recent Gallup poll found, just out, that 56% of Americans say they are better off today than they were 4 years ago with Obama and Biden. And that's rounding the turn, but that's during a pandemic. 56%, that's a record number, 56. You're better off today than you were 4 years ago with Obama. And, you know, I watched him today. They draw flies, both of them. I thought maybe they put them together. They draw a couple of horns, honk, 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 and most of them are our people that are taunting. Did anybody see the picture of their crazy bus driving down the highway? They're surrounded by like hundreds of cars, and they're all Trump flags all over the place. What a group. No, it's like a hot thing. See, that's really number one trending. You know, they won't put that. That's number one trending. They come up with number one trending. It's not a trend. It's whatever they want to do. You look at big tech. You look at what's been happening lately, right? You look at the media where they refuse to cover one of the biggest scandals. No, but the biggest scandal is we caught them spying on our campaign, right? We caught them trying to overthrow a duly elected, commonly known as me, President of the United States. Let's see what happens. Let's see what happens. Very dishonest people. You're right. Well, not you're right. You know, there are a lot of people that call that treason, okay? That's treason. Let's see what happens. If Biden gets in, the economy will collapse. Joe Biden is a diehard globalist who spent the last 47 years outsourcing your jobs, opening your borders and sacrificing American blood and treasure in endless foreign wars in countries that many of you have never even heard of. I didn't hear of too many of them either, if you want to know the truth. Biden is a Washington vulture who decimated your steel mills, annihilated your coal jobs, and supported every disastrous sellout trade deal for over a half a century. You know what's happened. You know what I had to do with the dump steel all over the place. They're dumping steel. I put big tariffs on, and all of a sudden, the steel mill started doing good. It was a beautiful thing. And we took some of that money, $28 billion we took, and we gave it to our farmers because they were targeted by China. And our farmers like me. Farmers like me. In fact, they just came out with the Des Moines Register poll. Did you see it? We're way ahead in Iowa. We're way ahead in Florida. We're way ahead in Ohio. Way ahead in Ohio. We're doing great in Georgia. Texas, don't even talk. You know, they're saying Texas is in play. I had the same thing 4 years ago. Here's a guy. He's against oil. He's against guns. And he's against God. I don't think that plays well in Texas. And you know where else it doesn't play too well? In a place called Pennsylvania. Oh, think of it. Okay, you have Texas. Oil, guns, religion. God, religion. So he's against, think of it. And then they say, it's too close to call. No, we're leading by a lot. Same thing happened last time, 4 years ago. It's too close to call. It's not too close to call. And then the polls close. Remember last time the doors closed, the polls closed? And they say, Texas, the doors have closed. The polls have closed in Texas. Donald Trump has won the state of Texas. It was like, by a lot. Oh, I had many of them. I had many of them. I mean, I have them now, but they're better now than they were 4 years ago. 4 years ago, it was like hopeless, except for one thing. Nobody believed it, and they went out and they voted. And all of a sudden, they took this thing. Did you ever see the New York Times? They had a little column, the chance of winning, and I think it started at like 4%. And then as the evening went by and we won state after state, Donald Trump has won the state of Florida, Donald Trump has won Georgia, Donald Trump has won South Carolina, Donald Trump has won North Carolina, Donald Trump, we're just running the East Coast, right? And it goes 3%, 6%, 9%, right? And the chance is 15%, then it started getting into the 50s. Then the 60s, that's where they started to go totally crazy. Remember that convention? Remember the convention hall? And then you had a couple of non-biased news anchors that started to cry. Did anybody see the debate? No, nobody, right? The last debate we had, right? Did you all watch? I felt like Perry Mason because the last question, I said, you mean you want to get rid of the oil and gas industry? No, we would like to transition out of it. I said, this is the biggest moment. It was like, you know, at Perry Mason, it was always that last question, right? No, I didn't do it. I didn't. Yes, I did it. I did it. That was Sleepy Joe. I said, this is the biggest moment. And even the anchor, Kristen, she looks up at him. She goes, why did you say that? Obviously being on his side. She can't believe that he said it, but that's because he's not too smart. Biden was a cheerleader for NAFTA and China's entry into the World Trade Organization, which is one of the worst things that ever happened to us, not to China. Eliminating half of your manufacturing jobs, many of them came from right here. At every turn, Biden twisted his knife into the backs of Pennsylvania workers. And you know, during that debate, he'd say, well, why didn't you do this? I said, why didn't you do it? You just left. Why didn't you do that? Why didn't you do it, Joe? That was like the easiest debate I've ever had. While Biden was giving China your jobs, his family was raking in millions and millions of dollars from the Chinese Communist Party. Joe Biden is a corrupt politician, okay? When his son can sit on a board of Burisma and get $183,000 a month. Now think of this, right? Think of this. If Biden wins, China wins. When we win, America wins. That's what we're here for. And you don't have to take my word for it because I like this group and I love this state. I spent a lot of money on that crazy board up there. Why don't you watch this?
I never said I oppose fracking.
You said it on tape.
I did. Show the tape. Put it on your website.
I'll put it on.
Put it on the website.
Would there be any place for fossil fuels, including coal and fracking, in a Biden administration?
No, we would work it out. We would make sure it's eliminated.
I guarantee we're going to end fossil fuel no more, no new fracking. I'd gradually move away from fracking.
And I think it's critically important on day one that we end any fossil fuel leases on public land.
What about stopping fracking and stopping pipeline infrastructure?
There's no question I'm in favor of banning fracking.
I have one final
question.
Would
he close down the oil industry?
It's false.
Would you close down the
oil? By the way, I would transition from the oil industry, yes.
Oh,
I would transition. That is a big
statement. In terms of business, that's the biggest statement.
Okay.
Because basically what he's saying is he is going to destroy the oil industry.
Okay.
Will you remember that, Texas? Will you remember that, Pennsylvania?
You know, we have to come together. That's why I'm running. I'm running as a proud Democrat for the Senate. So vote! Vote! Visit iWorld.com/Ohio. God bless you.
Can somebody tell Joe, by the way, it's not a real website, and Joe, you're running for president, not senator. And by the way, that senator, the Mormon guy, is Mitt Romney, not some Mormon governor. Now, sadly, what we showed you, that's just from a couple of hours today. Because every time that Joe actually leaves the basement bunker and stays out past 10 a.m., well, disaster ensues. Here's a quick reminder.
Look, tomorrow's Superstar Tuesday, and I want to thank you all. I tell you what, I'm rushing ahead, aren't I? We hold these truths to be self-evident. All men and women created by you know the thing.
If you agree with me, go to Joe 30330. We choose truth over facts. Play the radio. Make sure the television, make sure you have the record player on at night. The phone. Make sure the kids hear words.
Poor kids are just as bright and just as talented as white kids. Donald Trump does pose an excellent threat to this. It's not hypothetical.
This is pretty serious. By the way, these are way beyond an occasional campaign gaffe, and I am beginning, well, I'm more than a little worried that this man could represent a clear and present danger to this country. He's obviously not capable of leading. He's been hiding the entire campaign, and the corrupt media mob is covering for him. Joe wants to be the president of the United States of America. That would be the toughest job in the world. And at times, Joe doesn't seem to remember that he's even running for president, or what state he's in, or what day of the week it is. Does anyone really believe that if elected, that Joe Biden will actually be in control of anything?
What kind of country are we going to be? Four more years of George, is going to find ourselves in a position where If Trump gets elected, we're going to be in a different world.
I'll lead an effective strategy to mobilize true and international effort to pressure.
Spooky, creepy. Creepy Uncle Joe.
Oh, it's funny. It's Joe.
Come on, man! Candy's for the kids.
Maybe he forgot.
Wait a minute. You look familiar. Who are you?
Are we gonna let her get away with this?
She took everything.
Be careful. Joe, this could only happen to me. This could only happen. Thank you. In 2016, Pennsylvania voted to fire this corrupt political establishment, and you elected an outsider as president who is finally putting America first. That's okay, right? And if I don't sound like a typical Washington politician, it's because I'm not a politician. I guess that's why I got elected. If I don't always play by the rules of Washington and the Washington establishment, it's because I was elected to fight for you And I fight harder for you than any president has ever fought. I believe that. One of the most important issues in this election is law and order. And you know about it well. You see what's going on in your large city. It's not good. And you have great police, but they're not allowed to do their job. This week, violent mobs of Biden supporters ransacked Philadelphia. Now, four members of the city council are pushing very hard to defund the Philadelphia police. They're defunding the police. And they're pushing very hard, and it could happen. It could happen. We're watching. I don't think we'll let it happen. At some point, we can't let it happen. If Biden and Harris are elected, they will pass legislation to slash police funding. They're already trying to do it all over the country. Well, except in Republican cities and states, which are running beautifully without crime. Our opponents stand with the, take a look at it, the rioters and the anarchists and the looters. We stand with the heroes of law enforcement. We've been endorsed by almost every major law enforcement group in the country, Florida, Texas, New York's finest endorsed us, first time they've ever endorsed a presidential candidate. The Chicago police, that's not easy to do, they endorsed. We have endorsements from everybody. During the debate, I said, Joe, what law group, what any police group, anybody looking for law and order, did anybody endorse you? He couldn't answer the question. Then he was bailed out by the anchor, right? He was bailed out. I said, Joe, say the words law and order. He wouldn't do it. He didn't want to lose the radical left. I'm not just running against Joe Biden. I'm running against the left-wing media, the big tech giants, the rhinos. You know what a rhino is, right? Republican in name only. We got a couple of them. There aren't too many of them left. They're on respirators, actually. And the Washington swamp, which is much deeper and much more vicious than we ever thought even possible. On Tuesday, November 3rd, now maybe you do it sooner, but I think this group wants November 3rd. It's called Election Day. Of course, now that our United States Supreme Court has delayed everything, it's going to be a very interesting evening. And I wonder what happens during that period of delay with the ballots. I wonder what happens. Are they going to mysteriously find more ballots, Mr. Congressman? Are they going to find more ballots? Can you imagine what happened? Can you imagine? Just be very careful, be vigilant, and watch, and report whatever you see. Because, you know, this state, we love it. Went to school here, right? Went to college. We love it. But strange things have been known to happen, especially in Philadelphia. So send them a message that they'll never forget. This election is a choice between a Biden depression and a Trump super boom. We're gonna have a boom. We're gonna have the greatest economy ever. It's a choice between a deadly Biden lockdown. You know, he wants to lock it down. And by the way, tell your governor to open up your state, please. Can you believe it? Can you believe it? And open up your schools and get it going. It's terrible. This one, Michigan, how about her? The only one that's allowed to roam free in Michigan is her husband. He can do whatever the hell he wants. Nobody else can. In North Carolina, same thing. They got a great state, great people. They have it locked down. It's just crazy. By the way, on November 4th, he'll announce, ladies and gentlemen, we've decided to open up. See, he thinks he's hurting us politically. And then we have a number like 33.1. It might have been 34.1, okay? I don't think that would have made too much of a difference, but he's hurting a lot of people. It's a choice between a deadly lockdown and a safe vaccine that ends the pandemic with or without the vaccine. And we're going to have the vaccine. We have the greatest companies in the world, Pfizer, Johnson & Johnson, Moderna, and others. And we're weeks away from a vaccine, and we're going to give the vaccine. We're going to have it transported by our military all over, logistics all over the country, and it's going to be great. And it's going to be given to our seniors first. I think they have to get it first, and our frontline workers. Free, free. You know why it's free? Because it wasn't their fault. It was China's fault. And it will quickly eradicate the China virus, and but with or without it, it's going to go away, and we are rounding. It drives them crazy, the fake news media. It's going away. And if you look at Europe, you look what's happening over in Europe, they'd always use that as look at Europe. Well, take a look at Europe. They have a problem, a big problem, and we don't want that to happen. Thanks to our groundbreaking therapies, our excess mortality rate is 40% lower than Europe's. And right now, cases are surging in Europe despite draconian lockdowns. You know, they've been locking down and it didn't help them much, that are spreading misery and suffering and destroying those nations. For months, Democrats celebrated as left-wing rioters took to the streets by the thousands. You know, you're allowed to riot. They don't ask about masks. You're allowed to riot. You're allowed to go through, loot and burn stores, burn down your main streets, burn down the greatest, beautiful, the most beautiful shopping streets. You can do whatever. They can walk out with televisions. Did you see the guy walking out with dishwashers? He's pushing it along the pavement. And the police are told, don't do anything. Stand back. Stand back. No, we can't do it. Our opponents do not believe in science. They want unlimited power over you and your family. They got to open it up. The so-called experts advising Joe Biden have called for slowing down the vaccine. Can you believe this? Now, if it weren't, in my opinion, so political, they just didn't want to have it come out before the election. But everybody knows it's right there and we're ready to go. But it became a big political thing and they were actually trying to discourage people from taking it. It's so bad and so stupid and so dangerous. And these are great companies. These are the greatest companies in the world. They're not listening to anybody but their people. And we do. We have a great, well, soon, very soon be distributed this great vaccine. But they're willing to hurt our country in order to try and make sure that it doesn't, because we're not looking for credit. We're looking to save lives. We're looking to help our country, help your state, help our country. That's what we're looking to do. Denying priority to elderly patients. They want to deny the priority, imposing crippling lockdowns that will cause, quote, really serious pain. They've said that. One of the politicians said it. Really serious pain. The Biden lockdown will imprison you in your home while looters roam free. But you've already gone through that, in all fairness. You're going through it right now. They just don't open up the state. Congressman, you got to get going on this, I'll tell you. You got to get going on this. We have great congressmen here. We got to get going on this. Under Biden, there will be no school, no graduations, no weddings, no Thanksgivings, no Easters, no Christmases, and no 4th of July. Other than that, you're going to have a wonderful life. Now, think of this guy. Ruin American youth. You know, it's been shown that telehealth has been amazing with the computers, with the laptops. It's been great. It's up like 8,000%. The truth is it's great. But, you know, children, this has been proven now because we've had the ultimate test. Children have to go to school. They have to be with other kids. They have to be with classmates. And they don't catch it. Barron Trump, you know Barron Trump, my very tall son, he's strong and he's young. And the doctor said, yes, sir. He tested positive. I said, doctor, tested positive for what? He said, for COVID. You know, he used the COVID word, right? Could he use 21 other words, but he used COVID. And I said, oh, that's terrible. Doctor said, oh, don't worry about it. He'll be all right. 12 minutes later, the doctor called, Barron's okay now, sir. He threw it off like, because they're young and they have great immune systems, stronger than you or you or you. That guy definitely stronger than him. And they got to go back to school, okay? They got to go back to school. Open up Pennsylvania, Governor. If you want a vaccine to kill the virus, a job to support your family, and freedom to live your life the way you want to live your life, vote for a person named President Donald J. Trump. Have you ever heard of him? And the Republican Party. So joining us today are some really great, I mean, really great warriors, and they are Congressman Fred Keller. Fred, thank you. Thank you very much. Central Casting, doing a great job. Thank you. And Congressman Dan Muser. Dan, thank you very much. Thank you. Great people. Great people. They worked with us on the impeachment hoax. Now it turned out that it's really a hoax because they found out that I was right when I spoke to the president, right? I told them, I said, if you see anything wrong, please call the Attorney General of the United States. And they had plenty wrong. You look at Biden, he got caught. They call that the laptop from hell. Where's Hunter? Where is Hunter? Remember the t-shirt we made? Where's Hunter? Oh boy, Hunter. We also have a fantastic person who is running for a congressional seat and is doing very well, I understand. Jim Bognette. Where is Jim? Jim. Good. I hear it's going well, going good. Get out and vote for this guy. He's a star. It's going to be great. And a former congressman who's been a right early supporter, a great one, Tom Marino. Thank you, Tom. What a great... When are you getting back? Come on back, okay? Great one. And we have another great one. Nobody ever heard of him. Lou Barletta. These are great people. They're incredible people. Thank you both. That's great that you're here. And state treasurer, candidate, Stacey Garrity. Stacey, thank you, Stacey. I hear you're doing well, Stacey. I think the Republican Party's doing very well. I can tell you one thing. They are really worried because Florida, boom, through the roof. Ohio, through the roof. Georgia's looking phenomenal. Texas, I told you, forget it. It's like, great. Texas is so good. The Iowa is looking great. They're all looking good. North Carolina. You know what's looking really good? Pennsylvania. But get out and vote. You know, maybe I should say it's going to be. No, let me take that back. It's not looking good. It's very close. Looks like we're 1 or 2 points behind. It's always good. It's always good. Think you're about a point or two behind, right? These professionals, fellas, right? Think you're a point. I don't want to tell you we're doing good. Let's just say it's very close. Get out and vote on Tuesday. Just get out and vote. But it's true. You never know. You know, we are looking good. And I don't want you to think that. I want you to think it's going to be close. We're looking so good. Darling, we don't have to vote today. It's looking great. Oh, that's great. Joe Biden has been a disaster for African Americans and Hispanic Americans. I'm fighting for citizens of every race, color, and creed. We achieved record low African American, Hispanic American, and Asian American unemployment rates. Record low unemployment rates for anybody, with a diploma, without a diploma, number one needed class at MIT, women, everything. We have historic rates. And then we had to close it up and understand the disease, and what they've done is incredible. The ventilators, all of the things that we did. And then we're opening it up now, and it's going to be a super V. They were saying, oh, it won't be a V. Well, now 33.1, it's called a super V. We're going to have the best economic year in the history of our country next year. Unless you elect somebody that wants to do a quadrupling of your taxes. I don't know. I don't think that's going to happen. I don't think so. I signed landmark criminal justice reform, and I announced a platinum plan, which will create 3 million new jobs for African Americans, and also deliver school choice to any parent that wants it, which is so important. They've been looking to do that for a long time. To protect our security, I suspended the entry of foreign refugees from terror-afflicted nations, if it's okay with you. I mean, you don't mind. I don't think we don't want people from terror-inflicted. Think of this. Biden, in the manifesto, that's the agreement that he made with crazy Bernie Sanders. Well, I shouldn't say that, because we get a lot of the Sanders people. You know, people don't realize 4 years ago, we got a big percentage of Bernie Sanders because they agree with me on trade. They know everyone takes advantage of the United States in trade. And we are doing great on trade right now. Biden wants a 700% increase in refugees from the most violent terrorist hotspots on Earth, including Syria, Somalia, and Yemen. No thanks, Joe. Thank you very much. We appreciate it, Joe. No, thank you. The people of Pennsylvania aren't thrilled with that. Who the hell's going to vote for this guy? You know, they keep saying it's close. I don't think it's close. But get out and vote. It's close. It's extremely close. It'll be extremely close. Trump wins by 44 points. No, no, it's less. No, but think of it. He wants to raise your taxes the highest. He wants to let people in from places that you don't want them. We want to have safety and security. And that's why when you talk about suburbia, they were saying women of suburbia. Good. Thank you, Doug. That's because all they want safety, they want security, and they wanted the regulation terminated. The regulation was, you know what? I don't want to go into it. The regulation is a disaster for suburbia. And you know who's going to head up the regulation project is Cory Booker, of all people. Cory Booker. You too can have a development right alongside of your wonderful house. No, it's no good and no good. Going to bring a lot of problems. It's already done. I mean, you take a look at throughout the country, think where it's been done. And I terminated it. They wanted to amend it. Ben Carson's a wonderful guy. Ben came in and says, well, we can. He's a wonderful guy. He is. And he ran a good race, too. He's a great guy. He's a nice guy, and he's a great guy, and he's done a terrific job. But he came in and he said, we can amend it a little bit and make it tougher. I said, no, Ben, we got to terminate it. And then I hear the women of suburbia don't like me. I think they love me. I think they do. And when I said that the other day, I said, women of suburbia, I hope you love me. 60 Minutes, she said, you were begging for the love of women. I said, no, I wasn't. I was having fun. But you were begging. Here it is. It's true. I say, women of suburbia, you must love me after what I did. I cut the regulation. You don't know what the regulation was. That's... I love you too. I love you too. Just get out and vote properly. Just do what's right. You do what's right, we're going to have a big victory. The Biden plan, I mean, this guy had so many years to do all this stuff. All he does is complain. You didn't do this. Or really, why didn't you do it? You just left 3.5 years ago. The Biden plan will open the floodgates to radical Islamic terrorism. You know that. Just take a look. I called President Macron of France. It's terrible what's been happening over there the last week. You've seen what's been happening. And if you don't mind, I'd rather not have it happen over here. Is that okay? Do I have everybody's approval on that? Huh? Even these two veterans are saying, we agree with it. And I'm keeping the terrorists out of our country. And when they come back in, we're getting them the hell out of our country, okay? We invested $2.5 trillion in the U.S. military when I took over. 4 years ago, can you believe it? Almost 4 years ago, our military was depleted from all of these wars and all of this stuff and places so far away and lands that's so far away, and we were depleted. And a very highly overrated general, you've heard me say this, extraordinarily overrated, he came into my office and he said right at the beginning, sir, we have no ammunition. I said, no president should ever have that said to him again. And we built a brand new military with new planes and new rockets, right? Hypersonic. That's 7 times faster than our very fast one. So fast, you can't see it. Can't do anything with it. If it's aimed in the wrong direction, you got problems, I'll tell you. And submarines and all of the things we're doing, we've never had anything like it. We are the envy of the world. Russia, China, North Korea, we're the envy of the world. We have the greatest equipment in the world. We used to have planes, fighter jets. They'd go to the desert where they have what they call the graveyard, the plane graveyard, and they'd take parts off old planes and bring them in. This will, now we have brand new F-35 stealth, super stealth. Many others. It's amazing. We've rebuilt our military. It's never been so good. Never been. We've never had equipment like this. The best equipment anywhere in the world by far. And we saved a place called the Philadelphia Shipyard. I don't think you've ever heard of that. And Biden, if he comes in, will shut it down. He's going to shut it down. He'll shut down a lot of this stuff. We also passed VA choice and VA accountability. That's pretty great, right? They've been trying to get that done for 40 some odd years. Last night, at my direction, the United States military conducted a successful operation to rescue an American hostage who was kidnapped just a short while ago. U.S. Special Forces brilliantly executed a daring nighttime movement. It was incredible. I've seen it. It was incredible. And we had no casualties, no injuries. No, we had no casualties, no injuries, no nothing. Incredible. These are incredible people. These are incredible people, and they love our country. But they went in, and the other side did have a lot of casualties. And we got our citizen, our American citizen out, and on our way here. And it was an incredible operation. People said, oh, that can't be done. These guys looked at me like, sir, this is easy. It's a different kind of person, right? Different kind of person. We owe a lot, special forces. Over the last 4 years, we've rescued a record 55 hostages and detainees in more than 24 countries. And we don't pay, we don't pay. Once you pay, it'll go up 100-fold. You can't pay, you have to go get them. Yesterday's operation should serve as a stark warning to terrorists and thugs who try and kidnap our people, kidnap our citizens. You cannot escape the long reach of American justice, and that's what happened. We killed the leader of ISIS, al-Baghdadi. They've been looking for him for 18 years. We took out the mass murder of U.S. troops and many other troops and a lot of people. Soleimani is dead. Number one terrorist. I withdrew from the last administration's disastrous Iran nuclear deal, $150 billion. You know what we got? Nothing. We got nothing. I recognized the capital of Israel and opened the American embassy in Jerusalem. And I also recognized Israeli sovereignty over the Golan Heights. 52 years they've been negotiating that. I did it in 2 hours, and it was a good thing. Every president wanted to do this stuff. Every president of Jerusalem, they all wanted to do it. They all said they were going to do it. They got into office. They never had the guts to pull the trigger and do it. And I got the building built, too, by the way. You know that story. We got it built for a tiny fraction of what people thought it would cost. Tiny fraction. But it's too long a story, and it's too cold to be talking about the building. The heck with it, right? And instead of endless wars, we are forging peace in the Middle East. We have already 3 countries and many more lined up. No more blood in the sand, no more crazy money spent all over the place. No, we did it the opposite way that John Kerry and these people that were not smart. In fact, they were grossly incompetent. I said, you know how I started? I said, how did Kerry do it this way? Okay, whatever he did, do the opposite. And it worked. We have a lot of them all lined up. You're gonna have peace. Could have peace in the Middle East for nothing and no blood. I talk no blood in the sand. There's blood all over that sand. There's no blood in the sand. I'm proud to be the first president in decades who has started no new wars. No new wars. But if we ever do start a war, we'll finish it, and we'll finish it victoriously. We won't be playing games. A vote for me in the Republican Party is a vote to save our beautiful American dream. It's an American dream. And we've lost sight of that over a long period of years, if you think. Remember I came out and campaigned, I was up here, I said, you will say Merry Christmas again, right? The department stores, they would say Happy New Year, everybody. You know, the snow and the red and the white, everything perfect. But they didn't want to say Merry Christmas. I said, you're gonna say Merry Christmas. And now they're all saying Merry Christmas again. And we remember are the party of the late, great Abraham Lincoln, right? The late, great Abraham Lincoln. Over the next 4 years, in conclusion, we will make America into the manufacturing superpower of the world. And we will end our reliance on China once and for all. We will hire more police, increase penalties for assaults on law enforcement, and we will ban deadly sanctuary cities. We will defend the right to life, religious liberty, free speech, and the right to keep and bear arms, our Second Amendment. We will maintain America's unrivaled military might, and we will ensure peace through strength. We will end surprise medical billing, require price transparency, already signed January 1st, goes into effect, bigger than healthcare, you watch. lower drug prices even more, favored nations clause. We paid for years and years the most expensive by far in the world. Now we're going to pay the same as the lowest. And the drug companies do not like me too much, I will tell you. They're not a big fan of your president. They can't even believe I did it. Favored nations, we pay the lowest price in the world, protect Social Security and Medicare, and we will always protect patients with pre-existing conditions. Always, always, it's protected. America will land the first woman on the moon, and the United States will be the first nation to land an astronaut on Mars. And NASA is now again the talk of the world, Space Center, the talk of the world. It was boarded up, shut up. The runways were, they had grass growing through the cracks. It's an amazing place. And, you know, we let very rich people, they like sending up rockets. I said, let them send up all the rockets they want. Let them pay for it. We'll lease them their sites and let them go out and have a lot of fun. They'll become a little less wealthy, and that's okay. They don't mind. But they love sending up rockets, and we're doing things that nobody can even believe. And with Space Force, it's so necessary. So we're very proud of it. And Mike Pence has done a fantastic job on it. That's it. Really done a fantastic job. We will stop the radical indoctrination of our students and restore patriotic education to our schools. We will teach our children to love our country, honor our history, and always respect our great American flag. And we will live by the timeless words of our national motto, "In God We Trust." For years, you had a president who apologized for America. Now you have a president who is standing up for America and standing up for the great people of Pennsylvania, who I know very well. And you know, if we win Pennsylvania, it's over. You know that, right? Okay. Now you bet I'm freezing up here. I'm freezing. You better get out and vote. Sir, you lost by just a few votes in Pennsylvania. I say, what the hell did I make that trip for? You know, they said, you know, we could cancel if you'd like. It's been a long day. You know, I started this day very early. I said, no, I don't have the courage to tell these people there's no. Not only did we not, we're giving you the full treatment. We're giving you the full treatment. I could have done one of those, hey, folks, how you doing? Everybody good? Good. I'll see you later. Nah, we don't do that. But you get out there and vote because your country's at stake. You have the power with your vote to save the American dream for your children, for your grandchildren. But you have to get out and vote on November 3rd. We must finish the job and drain the swamp. We've done a lot of work on it, but it's deeper and more vicious than anybody thought. It's more vicious. Look at what's happening with these big tech companies and with, nobody told me this stuff. But you know what? They can't believe what we've done. We have come through situations that's amazing. You know, they cannot, look at them. They're sitting there, they can't believe. One of the reasons I also came is I wanted them to stand there all night in this freezing wind. Now, but it is an honor. I'll tell you what, I know this part of the state, and I know it, and you have just incredible people. There's no way I would have had the courage to say, let's not do that tonight. We'll do it some other time. There's no way we do that stuff. We don't do that stuff. We don't do that stuff, especially to you. For generations, America's destiny was made, forged, and won in places like Johnstown and Pittsburgh, Erie and Altoona, Bethlehem and Montoursville. That's a nice name. Our American ancestors gave their blood, sweat, and tears to defend our country and our freedom. We stand on the shoulders of American heroes who crossed the oceans, settled the continent, tamed the wilderness, laid down the railroads, raised up those great, beautiful skyscrapers, won two world wars, defeated fascism and communism, and made America into the single greatest nation in the history of the world. And the best is yet to come. best is yet to come. I mean that too, the potential we have. Unless we blow it by putting people that have no clue in charge. He has no clue. He's shot. Let's face it. Proud citizens like you helped build this country, and together we are taking back our country. We are returning power to you, the American people. That's what's happening. With your help, your devotion, and your drive, we are going to keep on working, we are going to keep on fighting, and we are going to keep on winning, winning, winning. We are one movement, one people, one family, and one glorious nation under God. And together with the incredible people of Pennsylvania, we have made America powerful again. Our military. We have made.
Thank you.
signing off from here, from Montoursville, Pennsylvania, where President Trump is going to go after 20 electoral votes in the state. I believe he'll get them, and I believe he'll be our president once again.